The judges for the fourth and last quarterfinal of the women's 51-kilogram flyweight competition are number one, Lithuania, number two, Philippines, number three, Sweden, number four, Cuba, and number five, Republic of Korea. The referee is Kira Sidi Yaku from Algeria. The boxers represent Bulgaria.
Approaching the Olympic boxing ring for her second bout of the tournament. Wearing red, representing Bulgaria, just has a little cheeky wink for the camera, is Stoyka Petrova. 26 years of age, and she boxed really impressively yesterday to book her place in this final eight. And now, entering the Olympic arena for the first time, beaming from ear to ear and really enjoying the moment, is Great Britain's Nicola Adams, the number two seed in this, her Olympic debut. By virtue of that seeding, she received a bye through the preliminary round. But what a moment for the boxer from Leeds, who she steps in front of the home fans for the very first time in the Olympic auditorium. And a lifetime dream is about to be fulfilled as she steps into the Olympic ring. The place where so many of her heroes, including Sugar Ray Leonard and a certain Cassius Clay, operated with such distinction all those years ago. The opening bell sounds for the first of a scheduled 4 2-minute rounds in the women's 51 kilogram flyweight division, and the boxer wearing blue, making her Olympic debut representing Great Britain, is Nicola Adams. She has made a fast start operating out of that orthodox stance, as she just has some good success down to the body. And her opponent from Bulgaria, wearing red, boxing out of the southpaw stance, is Stoyka Petrova in this, her second bout here at London 2012.
Well, these boxers know each other very well, Ron. They've met three times in the last year. And in all three occasions, Adams has come out victorious.
How much will that count for in the minds of both boxers on this? Totally different, the Olympic stage. Boxers are going to find inspiration from somewhere. How significant are those three encounters where Nicola Adams has come out on top in the previous bouts?
Well, Nicola Adams has such confidence in her ability, and that will of course help her. But who knows what's going to happen on this Olympic stage. Petrova will have been training as hard as Adams.
Petrova boxed really impressively yesterday to book her place here in this quarterfinal, final eight. A 23-11 victory as Adams really beginning to warm up. And her success bringing appreciative applause from this partisan home crowd.
Yeah, lands with a good left hand there. Just needs to get out of those clinches.
It was a 23-11 victory over New Zealand's Shona Fernandez. That saw Petrova arrive here at this quarterfinal stage. And it was a really measured performance, full of clever boxing. But she's in with the reigning European champion from Rotterdam last year, a three-time world championship silver medalist. That's the caliber of opponent that Petrova is facing. And she's an athlete who is absolutely brimming with confidence on this, her home Olympics.
Just listen to that cheer, Ron. A fabulous atmosphere here at the XL Arena.
And at the end of the opening round on Nicola Adams' Olympic debut here on her home patch at London 2012, it's Adams who leads by a score of 2-1. Let's listen in.
There we go. Adams throws the combinations there. She's great. She throws head and body combinations. You never know where the next punch is coming from. She changes the angle all the time. Great backhand there, pushing Petrova to the ropes. Here we see again, great right left, taking, snapping the head back of Petrova. An unanswered combination. Coach.
So into the second round we go in this women's 51 kilogram flyweight bout between the boxer wearing red, representing Bulgaria, Stoyka Petrova, and her opponent wearing blue, boxing out of the orthodox stance, Nicola Adams of Great Britain. And Lucy, what did you make of the instructions being given from Paul Wormsley and Dave Alloway, the man who was in the ring during that minute interval?
Yeah, Dave Alloway just saying that she needs to relax a little bit. She's a little bit tense. I mean, you can forgive her for that, Ron. You know, we're at the Olympic Games. This is her debut. So she just needs to relax. Nicola Adams is a master of the loose shoulders, the loose hands, the quick punches. She works best when she's relaxed. And it just takes a little bit for her to get involved. But Petrova is making use of this, using a long reach and a southpaw stance to make it difficult for Adams.
This is a contest between a southpaw and orthodox boxer. Reigning European champion is Nicola Adams, three-time world championship silver medalist as well. She takes a good left hand from Petrova. Good right hand response to the body from Adams. And Adams, as hard as she has trained and as much as she focused on this moment, there was a period a few years ago as she scores with a right hand left jab combination, reverse 1-2. There was a period a few years ago where she doubted whether she would ever compete at the highest level again. She suffered a back injury. She scores with a good left jab, which wins a roar of applause from the crowd. Suffered a back injury after falling down the stairs in 2009, which kept her out of action for the best part of a year. Didn't return to competition until 2010 in June. And during that time, she had to cope with the anguish and the demons of inactivity. But here she is, competing on the grandest Olympics, the grandest amateur stage of all in the Olympic Games.
Do you know, Ron, I've trained alongside Nicola for about 8 years now, and she is one of the she is so mentally strong. It took a lot for her to come back from that dreadful injury, and she has done so with glee and with enjoyment. You know, I don't think in that whole 8 years I've ever not seen her smile. She loves every part of the boxing and does it every day.
Well, as the bell sounds to bring about an end to round number two, Nicola Adams will be loving the scoreline because it is 5-3 in her favour. She's doubled her advantage. Let's listen in.
Great uppercut. A right hand there by Nicola Adams. And there we go. A great 1-2 there, forcing Petrova to stumble backwards. Petrova comes back with her own front hand hook, right hand, but she succumbs to Nicola Adams' counter-punching.
Two rounds have been completed. There are two rounds to go. It is scheduled for 4 2-minute rounds here in the women's 51 kilogram flyweight division between the boxer wearing red, Stoyka Petrova, a one-time European Championship bronze medalist and two-time participant in the World Championships, who just been put under a little bit of pressure now from Nicola Adams, wearing blue, representing Great Britain. So just approaching 30 seconds gone in this third 2-minute round in the women's 51 kilogram flyweight division between the boxer wearing red, Stoyka Petrova, and her opponent wearing blue, representing Great Britain, Nicola Adams, the number two seed in the competition, making her Olympic debut as she was the beneficiary of a bye by virtue of that number two seeding. And she has been boxing very well indeed. She led by 2-1 after the opening round. She extended that to 5-3. After two completed rounds of boxing. So here we are in the third round, and Nicola Adams is using all the fluidity and punch variety that is her hallmark as she scored effectively with some shots to the body.
Yeah, Nicola Adams is one of the hardest body punchers I have ever sparred or ever boxed. It's good to see that she's employing those body punches now that she's getting a little bit more confident in the ring there, because that really will slow Petrova down.
Beautiful straight shots once more from Nicola Adams, and she ends it with a right cross. And after just taking a look on a scouting mission during that opening round, perhaps a little bit of nerves on this her Olympic debut, the corner instructed her to calm down, just to relax. Nicola Adams has carried out those instructions to a T and is boxing in really rhythmic, fluid fashion here in round number three.
She's using that jab to much better effect now, Ron. She's range finding, the smallest boxer on the GB program, but she has the longest reach. And really, that jab, you've got to believe me, comes from nowhere. You think you're well out of range and you get thoroughly proven wrong.
So the bell sounds to bring about a conclusion to round number three, and the XL Arena crowd in London that is filled to capacity and perhaps beyond once again rise in unison, because Nicola Adams has extended her advantage. She leads by 6, 11 points to 5.
Yeah, nice and relaxed now in the blue corner, it seems, from Dave Alloway, the coach. We see there Nicola Adams throwing her combinations and landing, there we go, with a body and a head combinations, forcing Petrova to stumble her back once again. There we go, those body hooks that I was talking about before, they are so hurtful, Ron. And I'd like to see her use a few more of these going into the last round, because they really do put you off going anywhere near throwing a punch to Adams.
As we enter the fourth and final two-minute round, the boxer wearing blue, representing Great Britain in the 51-kilogram flyweight division, is Nicola Adams, and she has worked herself into a six-point lead and begun the fourth round in brilliant fashion, scoring with a reverse 1-2, right cross, left hand, as she swords with the same combination once again. Petrova has to overturn a six-point deficit, the boxer wearing red, for Bulgaria. But Adams just in complete control, controlling the distance with her feet and with her hands. And Petrova has been unable to find an answer in what is the fourth encounter between the two boxers. The previous three have all been victories for Adams. We wondered how significant that tally would be on this, the grandest amateur stage of all. But it appears as though, unless she walks onto an absolute sucker punch, that Nicola Adams is about to repeat those victories here in this, their fourth encounter.
Yeah, you can see the style now coming out from Adams. Low hands, beautiful movement, switching from southpaw to orthodox quite comfortably. She's proficient in both stances. And we see now Petrova desperately trying to find a way around Adams' style.
Left hand lead being fired out of that southpaw stance by Nicola Adams, who lists Sugar Ray Leonard and Muhammad Ali as boxers she admires, along with Sugar Ray Robinson, and those two legends of the ring, the former two, Ali, formerly Cassius Clay, and Sugar Ray Leonard, modeled their style, of course, on Sugar Ray Robinson. And Sugar Ray Leonard and then Cassius Clay began their rise to global prominence right here in the Olympic boxing ring, as Nicola Adams comes forward with a foray and just drives Petrova backwards. Lost her balance, touched down on the canvas, but it's just a slip, says the referee, so the gloves will be wiped clean. And the contest resumes.
Yep, well-renowned Nicola Adams as one of the most naturally gifted female boxers on the Great Britain squad. This is where we see her personal style. She trains with the Ingalls gym, which is in Leeds, a famous professional gym with Dominic and Brendan Ingall. And we can see that very relaxed, low-hand style, swift shots and great footwork.
So as the crowd begin to count down the closing 10 seconds, Petrova is reduced to chasing shadows beneath the ring lights in her attempt to pursue and land shots on Nicola Adams. But no doubt about the victor. After a consummate performance in 4 2-minute rounds of boxing, Nicola Adams is beaming from ear to ear after her Olympic debut, all smiles, and she has graced the same canvas as some of the boxers she most admires, such as Ray Leonard and Cassius Clay. And didn't she acquit herself well with a dazzling display on her Olympic debut?
Just look at this. Strong rear hand from Adams, followed by a left. Just moving out the way of that counter by Petrova. And I tell you what, they are strong shots, Ron. You know when you've been hit by Adams.
The moments of realization. The final bell has sounded and Nicola Adams raises both arms in anticipation of victory. The official verdict is just a few moments away.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by a score of 16-7
A little dance of delight from Great Britain's Nicola Adams as she soaks up the acclaim and the applause of this XL arena that is packed to capacity. Union Jacks waving all around us. And Nicola Adams, in a manner of her heroes, celebrates as she bows to all four sides of the ring in recognition of the fact that she is guaranteed a place on the Olympic podium. She's prevailed in her quarterfinal. She's made it through to the semi-final. She will stand on the podium regardless. The only question now is what colour will that medal be?
Look at that. Well-deserved smile.